What's going on, everybody? This is Gerard with MottoCigars.com, and today we're going to be talking about cigar wrappers. Now, the basic structural purpose of a cigar wrapper is to hold the binder and the filler together. However, it does much more than that. A wrapper, as a general rule, can contribute up to 40-50% of the flavor of a cigar. And the balance provided by the blend of the filler and the binder has also a contributing factor. So, there are also several other contributing factors to how much of an impact a wrapper will have. Now, you have two groups. You have the natural and Maduro, but there are also other several subtypes that vary from mild to full body. So right here in my hand, I have a natural wrapper, which is lighter, more mild of a leaf, while the Maduro is going to be naturally darker in color and with a more full-bodied influence. And wrappers can also vary in price. They can go anywhere from $8 to $60 a pound. And there's obviously a quality difference between the low end and the high end, and it's significant. But going back to talking about wrappers, a very good example is the Aroma Craft Intemperance line. It is offered in three different shades of wrappers. The Intemperance EC is the Ecuadorian Connecticut. And it's a milder of a smoke than these two. And even though these two are dark, but they're completely different wrappers, the Intemperance BA is a Brazilian Arapiraca, which will be a little bit fuller in flavor. And then you also have the Intemperance Whiskey Rebellion, which is a Habano wrapper. Now, out of the three, for me, my personal favorite is the Whiskey Rebellion Habano wrapper. It just gives those kind of hints that I like, more coffee, a little bit of sweetness at the end of it. Where the Intemperance is a little too mild for me, and then the Arapiraca just wasn't my type. But I believe that majority of the clients out there preferred the BA, which is the Brazilian Arapiraca, but that is completely subjective. Now, going back to talking about the balance between the tobaccos of the binder and the filler will have an influence on the wrapper itself as well. Now, speaking of which, we have a prime example right here in my hand. This is The Last Cowboy. That's the name of the cigar made by Sinistro. And we have it in a Maduro and a Connecticut. Now, they're not the same blend, due being that the wrappers will be a major influence here. The Connecticut is a bit of a more tweaked blend to accommodate the sweetness of the Connecticut, so therefore you can kind of taste those flavors, where the Maduro is not the same blend. Because if we put the Connecticut straight on this blend, the blend itself is not going to be balanced to accommodate the nuances that you want to notice of a Connecticut wrapper. So with that being said, this is the Corona size. We do have them on our website, so please visit our website for more information on these guys. If you want to know about the sizes and then the prices on them, just log on to MottoCigars.com, go to Sinistro, scroll down to Last Cowboy, and check out the prices and sizes that we have. Now, I personally have experienced a cigar that the balance was uneven, and it's my own personal blend. Yes, I'm a novice blender, that you want to call it. When I was in the Dominican Republic, I came up with a blend, and I wrapped it with an Ecuadorian Connecticut wrapper. And at first hand, after creating this blend, we smoked it. We loved it. It was amazing, very buttery cigar, very nutty, and just full flavor, but it was mild in the nicotine strength. And we smoked 3, 4, 5 of them. It was amazing, and I loved it. Now, it is I don't know if it's a rule, but I do know that when they roll cigars, they allow them to sit in an aging room for at least 20 days to allow the ammonia to alleviate from the cigar. And that's part of the experiment. So when we came stateside, obviously I had a bunch more of my blend, and I let it sit for about 3 weeks. And when I lit it, in between then I was smoking this thing like there was no tomorrow, because I love them so much. But once the 3 weeks to 4 mark hit, the cigar totally changed. It got very grassy, very harsh, and I didn't really like it anymore. I was wondering what's going on with my blend. And that's when I started making some phone calls and talking to people that influenced me and some mentors. And it came to my knowledge that the balance of my blend, unfortunately, didn't match up. So what I'm trying to say here is that within the filler in this cigar, there's a bit of leaves that are a little bit stronger than my desired flavor. And what happened, that stronger leaf, once it fermented, it overpowered that creaminess I wanted. And therefore, the balance had totally shifted. And that's something I will chuck up and I will learn and go back to the drawing board. And that's why that they have tweaked these two guys from each other in order to accommodate the Connecticut wrapper. So with that being said, thanks for tuning in. If you have any comments, please place them where they belong and I'll give you the answers. Thank you. Have a good day.